everyone, I'm back with another video. So today I wanted to sort through my basket here of Chewy findings. I have my box here. We're going to clean this up and I need to put some of this stuff away. I need to add stuff to this that I need to use up, and it's a mess. Like, I use this all the time, believe it or not. I'm always in this basket, but over time when I'm looking for stuff, I'll fill up the basket and then I just never use anything that I put in here. So there's stuff in here from Chewy Haws, and yeah, just like this. Like, I threw this in here after I did the haul, so it's like that needs to be cleaned up. And then after I get this all sorted and organized, and I can see what I need more of, what I need to pick up, and so forth. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get started. So in here we have some spacer beads and some gauze here. We have this bag of acrylic hose beads. So these are metal. These are metal beads. We have these clamshell print covers. Pens, which I need more of these, so this I can leave in the basket. I also have these head pins. I have a little bag of glass Wendells. This is a bag of clamshell clasps. We have these toggles for chunky chomps. Put that to the side. This is a bag of beads, chomps, and gold head pins. You can put that with the other. This is gold clamshell. We have these antique bronze beads. Put that there. This one is spacer beads. These are just beads, like gold. These are all beads. And some spacers, so I have to separate that later. I need to throw that bag away. We have some more spacer beads and more spacers. So I need a box just for beads, like silver, bronze, gold beads, and then spacer beads. So I need to separate. This is spacer beads. These are toggles, so I can keep these in here. This is, I think, one. Yeah, this is one. This does not belong in there. So I can use that up. There's more upstairs to these. Gentlings. There's charms that need to be put away. Stuff that's mixed, I'm gonna leave here so I can separate it and then put it away. Ear findings. Bag of these and like I think bronze, I believe. There's a lot. And I want to do something with all these vintage, like, B-taps and space bees and stuff. I want to do, like, a rustic type look, or, like an antique or historical, vintage, look in jewelry, just to use this stuff up. Because I've had it for a while, and it has the, finished look, like tarnish. It still looks okay, but it would be good in that type of like jewelry look, you know. And I have beads, I have findings, and I just need to use them up to make space for new stuff. And see, I was looking for these. I was looking for these the other day because I needed them in a project. All these like vintage looking spaces and Why is all this in here? It's just crazy. I think this is 2mm jump rings. See, I needed that as well. The spacers. Tabos. See, all of these bags of Tabos that have like 1, 2, maybe 3 in each, I can make bracelets with these, and I can use them up, and I can have these bags for other things. But having all this in here, I can't, I don't know like what I have, because it's just so much. See, I'm getting ready to drop some spacer bars. Vintage spacer bars. That is so awesome. I don't know, I love the vintage and historic look. It's so nice. I use a lot of metal. See, this is brand new. Crazy. Spacer, like vintage, like spacer, like this stuff here I need to just throw all this stuff in a bag and sort it later. This is another mixed bag. I have to separate, but a majority of this are clasps. But we have these jumbo clasps, which we can use in like keychains, even. Another mixed bag for chunky charms. See, that's what's left that I have of these clasps for the chunky charms. So I need to get more of these because I use these all the time. And I recently just got that. But I can also use these too. So these are an option. So you have these and I just had those. You know what? They're gonna pop up when I'm not looking for them. They're just going to appear. Keep those in there. I have gunmetal, I have gold. I have antique gold, I have bronze. But I want to get 6mm and 4mm clasps at each color. Because these I can use with little bracelets, and these I can use for necklaces. So and once I separate everything, then I can know like what I need, and we can start making a list. So I'm running low. I need gold in 4mm, antique gold in 4mm and 6mm. I need bronze. I need gunmetal in 6mm. Yeah, so I'm gonna go through this. We need more charm clasps. But I knew that I was running low. Because every time I try to go to make a necklace or even a bracelet, I'm having trouble finding lobster clasps. I can't find them. And this is the reason why. So I'm excited because that means I'm using up my material and I'm getting through it. Now, when it comes to spacer beads, that's one thing that I need to more so focus on. So we have toggles. We have a lot of silver toggles. We got more in these in this in my other box here. But yeah, let's put all these away and we will go. we'll go through these and see what we need, what we don't need. This is another video. So we have these Sabatagos that I just received. These are brand new, so I'm going to hold on to those for now. We have two of these dragonfly clasps that I need to use up, so we're going to put that to the side. We have one of these religious tavos that I can get through. We have a mix of these tavos, which I can use for bracelets. I'm gonna hold on to that. I have these flower, which I can use some for spring. So I'm gonna put these in my basket so I can use those up. We have some pots. We have a mix of like different tavos here. We have these that with the grapevine. So I thought these would be perfect for fall. So when fall comes, I'll use these up and I'll make necklaces with these. So I'm gonna hold on to this because I've had this for a while, but I think I can use this then. I have these antique clasps. So in here is all silver and some gold. Majority silver. That I need to separate, but I have a box of mixed metal too as well, so. So these I've had for a while, and I only have a few of these, so I'll put these back. See, I would love to use this because I have a project that I want to use these for, so I'm going to hold on. I'm going to keep those there. You can use those. You can use these up. Should be all the tavos that we're gonna use up. I'll put the rest of these back. This is sell my mixed metals. This is like gold, silver, no, gold, bronze, antique. There's even, I even have copper. But I don't really have any copper findings. I don't have really any lobster clasps or chain or ear, you know, I have ear wires. I have some clasps. I got some toggles here, but I don't really have like complete sets to make, you know, or the even the proper like color metal. This I got in beadlocks like a while back, so I'm gonna keep that in there for now. It's so cute. So I have these black toggles that I can use for Halloween. I need to get the ear wires, the jump rings, lobster clasps, chain. I think I have chain, but I need complete set so I can use it for Halloween. So that's something that I can hold on to for now. I have these bronze clasps. I have these in copper. Some of those up. I've had those forever too. And because it's spring, I should be using these up too. So I'll throw those in there and I can use some of those up. So just keep in here. This is all my jump rings. This is a huge amount of jump rings, and I got more here. Like, this is crazy. Alright, let's pull all this out so you can see what we have, what we're working with. Look at these antique, like, jump rings. Like, this would be perfect for, like, chunky charms, or even charm bracelets. That's probably what I would use that for. But I need to branch out and try different colors, because I always work with silver, and I have obviously a lot of like gold and bronze here, so I need to like switch up the so we have these rings. So these I'm not really using right now, so I put these away. I have these I think 8 or 10 millimeter split rings. I use them just yet. See, this mix bag I use all the time, so I'm gonna keep that in there. This is 6 millimeter bronze, so. And I think when I was on the website, I grabbed like 2 or 3 of these bags. And this is copper. I use those more. think these are soldered jump rings. Here's another mixed bag that I use often. You can see how much I put in here to use up, because there's just very few, and I use a lot of 6mm and 4mm jump rings, so, and I got plenty more in here, so I just, okay, so these are all the bead caps. These, I have a few of these somewhere. But these are gorgeous. When I found these, like, I was so, I thought these were so nice. So I have them even in Space of Beast too. So those are the bead caps in green, and I think, like, I should be using them for spring, because that's just screaming spring. But I have those. I have these filigree and gold, silver, and bronze. I even have one here. That's copper. This is bronze. I just really love filigree, because I have a lot of filigree. Like, yeah, I must have been in that mindset. So, not really used those up yet. to be great for fall, so I'm gonna hold on to those for fall. But I have a lot of these, and I think I want to start using some of these up. So I'm going to put a bag of silver, a bag of copper, and this antique gold put in here, and for the filigree. Bead caps because it's like overflow. These are my ear wires. Oh, this is gold and silver. So we have this antique gold vintage look that I've been using quite often, and that used to be a full bag. We have two sets of gold. This is a mix. I'll throw those in there. Been getting through that bag. I use those up. And so we got gold, we got silver. And the rest of these. And this is my mixed metal. See, I have a lot of copper. Ear wires. I got the black ear wires too. So I use bronze. So I got one gold, one bronze, and we also have silver. These are the head pins, and I only have one box of head pins, so I have like all different sizes. So the ones that are mixed, this seller that I bought from, she had a lot of like copper findings, and some of these are from Blog and Beatbox, but those are from that seller, and she had so many. Since I use these, I use them often. Seven. the space of beads. This is a lot. Like, this is so much. More vintage. See those with filigree and spaces. I was just in that mindset at the time. I bought them a bunch. See, I got these in silver and gold now. So I want to use those up because there's a look that I want to create. These. Same, I got them in daisy spacers too, in like two different shapes. Two different sellers. Thank you. producers. It's just insane. And crimp beads. And I think I already put some of those in there. All my copper findings in that same cellar. And yeah, so this is everything that we're going to be using up in jewelry, so I have everything that I need. In the next video, we're going to make a list of everything that I need more of. And so, hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.